Now, for the moment, I want to get back to this idea of moving along the elegance direction without changing the other dimensions. And that's often called refactoring. That is, we take a program and we change it around, so not that it does something different, but that it's clearer and easier to maintain. Now, here's a line from my hand rank program that bothers me a little bit. And what bothers me here is I'm repeating myself. So I'm asking, do we have three of a kind in the ranks, and do we have two of a kind in the ranks? Okay, if we do, that's a full house. And then what are we going to return? Six is the marker for full house, and then the three of the kind and the two in the kind. But I'm repeating myself. And so that violates what's known as the don't repeat yourself principle, or sometimes called dry. So I thought to myself, is there a different way to do this? Can I refactor my routine so that I'm not repeating myself, so that I only have to say this once? And in doing that, I came up with a different representation for a hand, for the ranks of a hand. So consider this hand. We have a 7, a 10, a 7, a 9, and another 7. Now, in the representation we have so far, and note I'm leaving out the suits here, they don't matter. The representation we have so far, we would sort these in order. We'd have the 10 and the 9 and the 3 sevens, and then we'd go through and we'd say, is there 3 of a kind? Is there 4 of a kind? Is there 2 of a kind? And so on. But I want to come up now with a representation that takes into account everything we need to know about this hand. And I can do that using this function that I'll call group. So we group this hand, and group is going to return two values. First, it's going to return the counts for each of the different kinds of card ranks. And so here we have 3 sevens and 1 10 and 1 9. And those counts are going to be sorted biggest first. And then the second value that groups is going to return is the card ranks for each of these. And so for the, what do we have 3 of? We have 3 sevens. And what do we have 1s of? Well, 10s and 9s. And we're going to put those in order of biggest first. So this representation of taking this hand and turning it into accounts and a list of ranks is in some ways a better representation of exactly how a poker hand counts. So here's the new hand rank function using this new representation for hands. So we call it in the same way, we pass in a hand, and now we create the groups and pull out the counts and the ranks, and then we do what we did before, where we say we have to deal with the ace high straight, and so change the ranks if we have to. And then similarly to before, we check to see if we have a straight or a flush. And now we can check for what the results are. And here we're returning a single number, 0 through 9, and in every case we return the ranks. So note what we're doing here is we're actually changing the signature of hand rank. This version of hand rank is going to return different results than the previous version of hand rank. But that's okay, because it's still going to work in conjunction with our evaluation, in that it's going to return the higher value for the higher hand, even though it's returning slightly different values. Why is it slightly different? Because we're only returning a single number, and then we always return the set of ranks, and those ranks are there even when they aren't needed. So for example, when we have a straight, we don't really need all the cards in the ranks. And in the previous version of hand rank, we only return the high card. Here we're returning all of them. And what we do is we go through and we say, what are the counts? So if the counts are just 5 of a kind, that's the highest. Otherwise, we check for straight and flush, like we did before. Otherwise, 4 of a kind. And the only way we can have 4 of a kind if the counts are 4 and 1. Otherwise, we check for a full house. The only way we can have a full house is if the counts are 3 and 2. Then we look for flush and straight. Those are next in order. Then we look for 3 of a kind. The only way to have 3 of a kind is 3, 1, 1. Two pairs has to be 2, 2, 1. One pair has to be 2, 1, 1, 1. And then high card would be 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. But we don't have to explicitly check for that. We can just have 0 as the final value. So this is simpler. We're not repeating ourselves. We have a nice representation here. Also, one thing that I really like about this representation is it showed me a new fact about poker hands that I had never realized before. And that if we look at these values, 5, 4, 1, 3, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, and then here, I haven't written it, but it would be 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. These are all the partitions of the number 5. So in mathematics, a partition of an integer is the set of numbers that add up to that integer. And for the number 5, that partitions into seven possible ways. And it turns out that poker recognizes all 7 of those as a different thing. So poker has a name for all the partitions. And the even more amazing thing is, look, they're in lexicographic order. If we sort the 7 partitions, they're in exactly the same order as the poker hands. 5 comes first, that's the highest. 4-1 comes next, that's the next highest, and so on. I never knew that before about the mapping between poker hands and partitions, but this representation of hand rank makes it clear.